Welcome to a new playlist that I am going to try to create. It'll combine elements of the men's right movement with cooking, actually. In a future video, I'll explain why those things have become synonymous, or not synonymous, but related in my own struggles in the men's rights movement that involve the men's rights movement. So this is not the Charles Carroll Society. This is going to be a separate playlist that I'm going to create. I don't know what I'll call it quite yet. You know, men's cooking, men's rights cooking, MGTOW cooking. I'm not really sure. I don't know. Perhaps MGTOW cooking is perhaps not the the thing that I should call it, but I'll see what we can do. So, but anyway, it'll be something related to men's rights, activism, and cooking. I'll go over why that is. I've been thinking about this. One of the things before we get into cooking and launching this new playlist on our channel, I wanted to thank my Patreon subscribers, Patriot Prepper and Jefferson Franklin. Thank you guys so much for your donations and your support. You guys have enabled me to buy this teleprompter here called the Parrot Teleprompter. And this teleprompter is one of the least expensive. It was crowdfunded. It's one of the smallest, but it works for what we're doing. And so now you won't see so many cuts in the videos because what I was doing is reading the paper, kind of memorizing the paper and looking back up at the camera. So now I actually can look, and hopefully this will improve the experience here with this, with, you know, my doing videos. So thank you, Patriot Prepper, and thank you, Jefferson Franklin. So if you guys like to support the channel, the Patreon link will be in the below, and really appreciate it. Those guys are, it's a bill for them, and I want to thank you very much for helping me buy this a little upgrade here. So I've been thinking about this this new segment for my channel, Men's Cooking, whatever, Men's Right Cooking, for a long reason. And one of the reasons why I've decided to do it right now is because an issue come up, and I really wanted to respond to that issue. But first, I wanted to launch this kind of separate, you know, approach to this playlist. So first, I want to set out some expectations for this new men's cooking, men's right cooking channel. I know I've attracted a lot of interest from extremely conservative Christians, both here and abroad, but you know, I think that this men's right segment may include some subject matter and topics that you might find at least a bit controversial coming from strictly a conservative Christian view. You know, I myself combine my traditional Christian conservatives with libertarianism, or trying to have as much freedom and free will and minimal laws as possible. So in this case, I will really be exploring the men's rights movement. And the men's rights movements have become, they don't believe in what they call trad cucks. They don't believe in traditional approach. They really, a lot, not the men right, but MGTOW, some segments of the men's rights movement, or if you want to call it a separate movement, whatever, are very hostile to the very concept of entering into permanent relationships with women nowadays. In 2018, would you recommend your son or your grandson to marry a woman he met who's a feminist or whatever, without a prenup or whatever? Would you even recommend that he marries such a girl? So they take a pretty hostile view. So I just want to give a heads up to a lot of my Christian conservative subscribers that we'll be talking about subject matter and concepts that, you know, that some religious people may not agree with. So just, you know, take a look at that. I personally don't have a real big issue with this. All of my videos that will be concerning this will be tagged either MGTOW in the subject, or men's right activists, or men's right cooking, so that way you can easily skip them if you wouldn't like to. I might create a separate channel to focus on men's right cooking, or MGTOW cooking, or whatever I'm going to end up calling it. But I have such a small channel as it is. I think it seemed stupid at this time to split my subscriber base instead of doing that. So I'll just keep it as a playlist that you can exclude. Also, some of the videos that when we talk about men's issues and men's issue with women and men's right activism, some of these I will select to be 18 and up, which means that YouTube kind of puts them, I'll put them myself into a state where children shouldn't have access to these. I'll self and say this is a really an adult subject matter. This greatly limits the spread of these men's right cooking videos that I'll be putting out and these ideas. But, you know, in my opinion, I think it's the fair and appropriate thing to do. I wouldn't want kids to be involved in some of the things when we start talking about divorce and the nastiness and the aggression and the evil that happens in our society. I think there's some things that we really don't need to take a look at. So, you know, I'm going to let you know that, you know, I'm going to check that box on some of the videos that talk about more more significant subject matter. Really, the only real reason I'm decided to start making these men's right cooking videos is to help me personally. That's why I started blogging in the first place. There's a lot of emotional, stressful issues, and I find that to have this kind of online diary of what's going on to help my emotional stress. So if you want to get these these men's right cooking videos, please ensure that you subscribe and click the little icon that is in on there. Somehow YouTube makes you subscribe twice, because like I said, some of these videos, I'm going to personally click the 18 and up button and so it won't show up in your feed. Next, this is primarily a men's only space. I really don't care to get into flame wars with a bunch of hateful women on my men's right cooking. I don't really care about what you think about women. This is for us men. And we're actually going to be talking a lot about cooking. Like I said, this is something that I've gotten into because of my my current situation. You had to become much more self-sufficient, and come to find out, guess what? Not as hard as you thought. And so I'm gonna talk about men's right issues and cooking from that perspective. So, you know, let me know. So I don't really wanna get into flame wars. I really try to respond to every comment. So I'm just letting you know that I'm probably not gonna be responding to a bunch of hateful female comments, because we're moving on. We wanna move on and kind of go and do our own thing without being dragged back into arguing with the other sex. Now for my red-pilled friends. First, I have to let you know that from a men's right kind of perspective, you know, I've been following the men's right movement for a very long time. I mean, for years. I wouldn't call myself an activist in the men's right movement, but I have literally been following it. And now that I have my own situation, I have found that a lot of things that the men's rights movement, the men's right activists have achieved, is keeping me afloat. And that is something that I did not really realize. There are some things, and I'm going to go over that in the future, that the men's right activists and the men's right movement, MRM and MRAs, really have done to keep me alive. And MGTOW, by the way. The concept of MGTOW, you know, I'm not MGTOW myself, although, well, right now I am MGTOW, but I call myself living a bachelor life currently. In the old days, it was a bachelor. They had a bachelor tax. Men who refused to marry women, they wanted to tax more. Literally, that's a true statement. So I consider myself a bachelor. I don't know really the difference between that. It's just kind of, I guess, the reasoning I'm doing it, not what we're doing, but no females in my personal life at this time. However, I really agree with the objectives of the men's right movement, men's right activists, as I understand them. I just want to let you know that I'm a newly red-pilled guy, even though I've been kind of studying it. I do want to change our current social and legal system. That's one of the things that I really respect and I support of the men's right activists. I want to change the current system. And I actually think there's people in the MGTOW who say, until the system changes, this is what we have to do. But the ultimate objective, as I understand it, is that the system has to change. If the system is not changing, then we're done. And I think that we should change the system for young people coming up under us. There are men and children and young men who are coming after us. And so we should cut that ice and try to improve the situation, just like our fathers and uncles allowed the second wave feminists and third wave feminists. And now we are fighting the fourth wave feminists to come up and put us in this horrid situation that we are in now. So I may tag these videos mostly with the MGTOW tagline, even though I know that that's a either subculture of the men's right movement or a separate one. If I tag them on MRM, I don't think many people know what that is. So I'm not claiming that everything I say is MGTOW. Like I said, I'm much more of a men's right activist myself. I think I can relate to a lot of what motivates that. I wanted to make these, men's right videos for a long time. And I haven't done it previously because I'm going through my own dark chapter in my life, and dark chapters in men's lives often attract extremely nasty feminists who intrude upon your life. And thus, I really don't want to give this nasty woman any extra ammunition, so you'll see me talk about things and not the most direct route, because, you know, you may need to see that in court, so you got to be cautious until this situation has fully resolved itself. However, I have to say, in all honesty, that if I had not found MGTOW, if I had not found the men's right movement, I would have never woken up to some of the core issues that were really harming me in my personal life. And I don't know if I would have had the strength to change my life, to demand a change in my life. And I would have never understood so much and have been prepared for what would come when you decide to change your life. Thus, I have to say thank you for those who've come before me in the men's right movement, MGTOW and all that, and have and I'd really truly believe the social media presence of men's right activists, the social media presence of the men's right movement have really helped me live through a very evil time in my life in modern Western nation. You know, it was men's rights movement and MGTOW related blogs and social media channels. They're the ones who let me understand that men are 8 times more likely to commit suicide during a divorce. It wasn't GQ magazine. It wasn't, you know, the news. It wasn't the mainstream news. These guys don't care. As long as men are killing themselves, it seems to be a disproportionate men are dying. Sperm counts are dying. Testosterone is being dropped off. Men are killing themselves. It doesn't seem to be an issue that really bothers them. But it was men's right activists and men's right movement who really highlighted this. It was the men's right movement in MGTOW that explained to me that 70% of divorces are initiated by women. Remember, add those two things up. Men are 8 times more likely to commit suicide during a divorce, and divorces are 70% initiated by women. Women are killing men through divorce. That's amazing. You know, it was not the mainstream media who explained to me that in almost all divorces, men lose access to their own children. They're forced to pay for them, to have, you know, slavery to money, but then they lose the ability. You have to financially support a family that you cannot be emotionally and physically a part of. That is a heinous evil. And I think a lot of men who may be going through their own trial and tribulation, one of the reasons they get smacked around so much is because they don't know what to expect. They're stunned when they come in and see it. But it was the men's right movement in MGTOW and social media that prepared me to a degree. I mean, we all still suffer when we have to go through our own issues, but at least, you know, I feel that I was able to brace for impact. So I would like to say thank you to all those who came before me, and thank you very much. Now, more MGTOW videos will follow. Iron sharpens iron. Iron sharpens iron.